Good morning, Issa and Skriven. So, in our last class, we studied about types of farming, isn't it? From geography chapter, agriculture. So, today our topic is cropping pattern. Okay. So, and you know that cultural plurality and the physical diversities also reflects the agricultural practices and a cropping pattern in India. So, various types of food and fiber crops, vegetables, fruits and spices, etc. constitute some of the important crops grown in our country. Okay. So, India has three cropping seasons. They are Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. Okay. All these words, see Rabi, Kharif and Zayed, all these words derived from Arabic language. Okay, now we can study in detail about this three cropping seasons. So, the first cropping season, that are Rabi crops. Especially this Rabi crops sown in winter from October to December and harvested in summer from April to June. Okay, see which are the important crops are cropping in this season: wheat, barley, peas, gram and mustard. Okay, so states such as Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Western Uttar Pradesh are main Rabi crops. Mainly they are producing wheat. Okay. So, availability of precipitation during winter months due to the western temperate cyclones help in the success of these crops, these Rabi crops. So, the success of Green Revolution in Punjab, that we studied about Green Revolution. So, the success of Green Revolution in Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan has also been an important factor in the growth of Rabi crops. Okay. So, now you clearly understood about Rabi crops, I think. These are sown at the start of winter season, that is especially from October to December, and harvested in spring season or at the start of summer, that is from April to June. Okay, so now we can study about the second type of cropping season, that are Kharif crops. Okay, this Kharif crops sown with the onset of monsoon in different parts of the country and harvested in September to October. Okay, these crops are grown during the monsoon in different parts of the country. These are harvested in September to October. See, the major Kharif crops are paddy, maize, jowar, bajra, thur or arha, moong, urad, cotton, jute, groundnut and soyabean. Some of the most important rice growing regions are Assam, West Bengal, coastal regions of Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Maharashtra, particularly the Konkan coast along with the Uttar Pradesh and the Bihar. They are using which cropping season? Kharif cropping season. Recently, paddy has also become an important crop of Punjab and Haryana. Okay, and in states like Assam, West Bengal and Orissa, three crops of paddy are grown in a year: Oz, Aman and Boro. These are the three paddy crops that grown in a year. Okay, so the Kharif crops grown during the monsoon in different parts of the country and these are harvested in September to October. Okay, then moving to the third season, that is Zaid crops. There is a short season in between Rabi and Kharif season, that is from March to June. This is This season is known as what? Zaid season. Some of the crops produced during this are watermelon. You can see the beautiful watermelons are there. Watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and fodder crops. Okay, and sugarcane take almost a year to grow. Okay, so Zaid season is a short season in between the Rabi and the Kharif season during the summer months. Crops produced are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables and the fodder crops. Okay, now I am giving you a higher order thinking question. So that question is, why sugarcane, tea, etc. are not included in any of the three cropping seasons like Kharif, Rabi and Zaid? Okay, we'll repeat the question. Why sugarcane, tea, etc. are not included in any of the three cropping seasons like Kharif, Rabi and Zaid? Now itself, send me the answer of this question and other questions regarding this topic. I'll send you to your WhatsApp group. Now you send the answer of this question. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.